You will ask in doubt if you have any. And even if you have not studied, then still we can quickly look over various notations or UML diagrams that we have to design the object-oriented softwares. Okay, so as expected, obviously. So if you have not studied, it's fine, but in the due course, and at least before the examination, you will study those topics. I hope. Okay, so software engineering subject आपने शायद पढ़ा होगा या पढ़ रहे हो. तो सॉफ्टवेयर इंजीनियरिंग सब्जेक्ट कवर हो गया आपका. ओके, सो इट्स गुड. सो यू नो बेसिक मॉडल्स लाइक वाटरफॉल मॉडल्स, स्पाइरल मॉडल्स एंड ऑल. सो यूनिफाइड मॉडलिंग लैंग्वेज, बेसिकली द यूएमएल इज अ ग्राफिकल मॉडल लैंग्वेज दैट प्रोवाइड यू सिंटैक्स बेसिकली टू डिस्क्राइब द मेजर एलिमेंट ऑफ द सॉफ्टवेयर सिस्टम. सो वाई वी नीड, सो हमें क्यों जरूरत पड़ी यूएमएल की बेसिकली. सो देर वॉज अ इंटरेस्टिंग एग्जाम्पल वॉज गिवन इन द नोट्स दैट आई हैव रिसेंटली अपलोडेड, दैट इन अदर फील्ड, इन अदर एरिया ऑफ स्टडीज लाइक मैथमेटिक्स, दे हैव अ कॉमन लैंग्वेज. सो फॉर एग्जाम्पल, इफ यू draw integral sign, then over the world all the mathematician will recognize it. Okay, so this is the method, this is the sign of integral, and implicitly all the educators, all the mathematician will understand, okay, what it is. So there is a common language in other fields and notations in the other fields, but in software systems we deal with the programming languages, and there's no a common programming language that is used by all the developers across the world. So, and because with the interest or with the easiness or with the applicability of particular language, a developer you select particular language to develop a system. So, but there is no common language that through which all the software developers or all the in the software development process all can communicate with each other, even if they are from the different languages or they are from the different field. So that's where UML comes. So it is called Unified Model Language. So it is basically used to describe the major element without going much into the detail of the development side. So you have seen some of the stages in software modeling and software development and software engineering, like planning, communication, design, development, testing. These are some of the stages that you have seen. So before developing a software system, we use a common language to communicate with all other stakeholders, like tester, which is using some another language, or programmer, even the client or the user that are going to use the software. So UML is one kind of language that is used. So now one thing is the object orientation part. So we have seen earlier in the programming side when why we use object orientation, object orientation concept in software development, because most of the real world softwares are based on the objects, and it is much closer to the real world. So we can relate objects to the real world rather than the functions or simply the data that we use in the procedural oriented programming. And also it also provides you different properties like encapsulation, data hiding, inheritance, polymorphism, and abstraction, one of the important property that object-oriented programming we use. So we can use, so irrespective of any language, you can use UML to describe the various component in the software system and various design concepts in the whole computer system. So we have discussed one of the diagram, what is called class diagram, where we have seen how to define a class, abstract class or interface, and how they can interact, how to define the inheritance, or basically generalization, specialization, aggregation, composition. We have seen the syntax of UML, where how you can basically draw the class diagram. So class diagram is actually gives you the snapshot of all the classes that you are going to use, basically all the objects that belongs to those classes that you are going to have in your software system. Another one was the use case modeling. So main ek kaam karta hu, main wapas main slide open karta hu jo aapke sath mein share ki thi. Okay, so this was I have shared with you. So UML, Unified Modeling Language, includes set of graphic notation techniques to create visual models of object-oriented software intensive systems, and it can be used with all the processes throughout the software development life cycle, all the stages. So normally each step you can define the system basically on the pen and paper using the diagrams. So building blocks of UML, so class, state, objects, and the relationship between those objects and class, and diagrams. So diagrams, we have use case is one of the diagram that we use, class diagram and collaboration diagram, activity diagram, state diagram. So these are all the diagrams. Class diagram we have already studied, so I'm skipping that particular part. We have also seen the cardinalities and different types of cardinalities. Okay, so kyunki wo humne padh chuka tha, main beech mein ek question puchna chahta hu aapse. One second. So what is the difference between cardinality star and if I write one dot dot star? I've written on the chat also. So what do you think, what is the difference between star and one star, one dot dot star, and also which one is more trickier in terms of cardinality between the objects? ओके, जब तक आप सोचोगे दोनों का आंसर, मैं अब तक स्लाइड पे चलता हूँ जहाँ पे हमें स्टार्ट करना है. Yes, so in cardinality one or star is more strict here compared to star, because star means many and we are not restricting how many. So, and in case of one, the minimum is one and then goes to many more. So another diagram, there is one of the important diagram in UML, which is called use case diagram, and it is one of the powerful tool to describe this interaction between user and the system. And normally when you draw a use case diagram, it usually describes using the verb noun combination. For example, let's say pay bill, update information, create account. So these are the verb nouns, verb or noun combinations we use to describe the use cases. And suppose, for example, if you are writing a missile control system on NASA, in NASA, so typically use case will be fire missiles or issue countermeasures that you can take in case of ATMs or ATM system, banking system. One of the use case will be withdraw money. So use case actually gives you the details of what are the activities, functionality that a particular user can perform. And since use case is the jo particular use case hai, it is described with a particular use case like borrow, reserve, order, title, fine payment. These are the use cases. Now, all the use cases cannot be initiated actions on its own. So, jitne bhi action ye likhe hain, ye khud apne apne initiate ho sakte hain. Actors is someone who can initiate the use case. So, for example, if you are developing a banking system, then we have use cases called withdraw money. Then we would identify that we require customer to be able to withdraw money. So, withdraw money, let's say. Example हुआ आपका use case का, तो cannot be done its own on its own. So a user, a customer is required to show that this customer will initiate that particular use case. So actor notation is also very very much simpler. You can define the actor, particular actor, like in case of bank system, it will be a customer. That will become a actor, and you write all the use cases that an actor can perform. Though in this particular example, where in library system you see there are three types of actors are there: client, employee, and supervisor. Okay, one more thing. So that square box is not necessary. You can avoid it. The main entities are the use cases written in the elliptical form and the actors. And also you can see some of the use cases might be overlapped between the different actors. So use case is one of the simplest diagram that depict all the number of users that your system can have, and what are the activities all the users can perform on the different types of user can perform on the system. So it's give you a complete idea what is there in your system and what is outside the control of the system. That is, those use cases are not defined, it is not covered in the software system. So though this particular example, you see all the actors are actually pupils, but sometimes an actor can be anything external to the system that initiate a use case. So sometimes it is not necessary that a particular pupil or particular human being will be the actor. Actor can be anything in the use case who can initiate the use case, initiate the action basically. So इसके एग्जाम्पल के लिए लेट्स से suppose you have scheduled email on the Gmail to send it at let's say at 12 p.m. let's say, or 12 a.m. whatever the time you have scheduled on the Gmail. Now, so the use case, as you were the user, the use case was the scheduler Gmail, so scheduler mail to be sent. And now at that particular time, you are not sending the mail, it is the Gmail is sending the mail. So Gmail is the actor at that time. So, so at that particular time, Gmail becomes the actor to send the mail. Send mail के लिए जो use case के लिए जो होगा वह Gmail होगा actor. So it is not necessary that only people or the human beings can be the actors. In the use case diagram, it can be any external event, that any external system or anything that is external to the system that can initiate a particular use case. It may be some another computer system also. Even it can be a more abstract terms like time or date. It could be a use case actor in the use case diagram. For example, if you have set, okay, so deadline is there and you have set the deadline, whose deadline to which task hai, so that particular deadline in terms of time and date can also be the actor. So most of the system, a single actor can interact with many use cases, and single use case can be initiated by the many actors that is shown in the library system also. And that basically define whole modeling of the system, complete system, and those are not there in the use cases are not the part of the system. So this is one of the simplest notations. So you have three basic component of use case diagram: system, actor, use cases, and relationship. System, a system is a piece of multiple pieces of the software that perform the function. It's possible to system a subsystem. So, okay. So use case में आपके पास एक तो एक्टर है. एक्टर रिप्रेजेंट समथिंग दैट यूजेस अवर सिस्टम. इट कैन बी पर्सन और द अदर सिस्टम आल्सो. हाँ, सो वन ऑफ द बेसिक कन्वेंशन दैट यू शुड अवॉइड गिविंग नेम दैट रिप्रेजेंट रियल पीपल इंस्टेड लाइक जैसन और मे बी अमित और एनीथिंग. बेटर गिव द नेम बेस्ड ऑन द पर्टिकुलर जॉब टाइटल दैट अ पर्टिकुलर एक्टर विल हैव ऑन द सिस्टम दैट इज यूजिंग द सिस्टम. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, दिस पर्टिकुलर सिस्टम एंट्री डेटा लेवल डेवलपर, चीफ CTO इज द सीनियर डेवलपर, प्रोजेक्ट मैनेजर. सो यूजिंग द टाइटल ऑफ द जॉब दैट विल गिव यू अ बेटर आइडिया, दैट विल गिव द बेटर आइडिया ऑफ the use cases that are going to be performed by the actors. And okay, so you can see so relationship in the use case diagram. You can also show the relationship use case to use case relationship. A parent use case can have a child use case which has their own children. Actor to actor relationship also there. An actor can be subnetted. For example, here cook, a mother cook and father cook, and the mother cook is cook Y, cook Chinese, and cook Chinese again as the sub use case, cook diet, cook dinner. Sometimes this relationship you can also, but it is always recommended to have a clear distinction between the users. So giving a simplest use case diagram is always helpful for defining the system. One other thing that is, I think, it is not mentioned here, so let me tell you about it. One is user case granularity. Sometimes आपको use case लिखना है तो What are the use cases you can think of? So normally, let's say even if you talk about withdraw money, these are the so this can be the following interaction in between the withdraw money. So like आप कार्ड इंटर करते हो, देन पिन इंटर करते हो, अमाउंट सेलेक्ट करना, देन कंफर्म करना, देन रिमूव कार्ड, टेक रिसिप्ट. सो बेसिकली इवन विड्रॉ मनी हैव लॉट्स ऑफ इवेंट्स और इंटरेक्शंस विद इन द सिस्टम. सो कैन ऑल दिस इंटरेक्शन बी द यूज केस? एंड सो बेसिकली नो. सो व्हेन एवर यू राइट यूज केसेस, दोज अचीव द गोल ऑफ द एक्टर्स. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, टेकिंग द रिसिप्ट परफॉर्मिंग द ट्रांजेक्शन वॉज नॉट द गोल ऑफ द यूजर एक्टर और द कस्टमर. बेसिकली सो द गोल ऑफ द कस्टमर वॉज टू विड्रॉ मनी, वेदर रिसिप्ट आए चाहे ना आए, उसके सारे टास्क, उसका जो बेसिक जो गोल है वो इट इज अ विड्रॉ मनी. सो यू हैव टू हैव यूज केस मोर हाई लेवल एब्स्ट्रैक्ट यूज केसेस. यू शुड यूज हाई लेवल एब्स्ट्रैक्ट यूज केसेस रेदर देन गोइंग विद अ कॉमन सीरीज ऑफ इंटरेक्शंस इन दैट पर्टिकुलर यूज केस. सो दिस इज द आइडिया ऑफ यूज केस डायग्राम. यू कैन गो अहेड विद द सम ऑफ द notations of use cases, and you can see. Okay, so there is an include relationship. This is normally when we use in the use case diagram. In this form of interaction, a given use case may include another. So first use case often depend on the included use case. So record grades, for example, it include save grades. And update grades also include the save grades. So you normally write the include relationship with the dotted line and showing at the other use case that it has. And you have to mention that include. Include relationship on the edge. Another relationship in use case is extend, which shows that a given use case, it can extend another. For example, log error extend the valid users. So normally, designer use the extend relation to indicate the use case that are optional to the base use cases. These are the two basic include and extend you use in the use case diagram. This is an example you can see for the use case diagram. There are some other diagrams also. So I would suggest you to go with that particular notes I've uploaded and see other use cases, other diagrams that we have in the UML. One of these collaboration diagram. So to show how the objects collaborate with each other, we write a high level collaboration diagram. And for the notation, we use a square, actually a rectangle, to show the different objects and how they collaborate. We write on the edges of the connecting edges of the objects. So you go with that particular PDF to understand the collaboration diagram. And there is another diagram which is called sequence diagram. So अगर मैं एक example, मैं एक second, इसकी जगह मैंने जो अभी अपलोड किया आपको वही ओपन करके दिखाता हूँ. Okay, so this is how the collaboration diagram looks like. When you're developing object-oriented softwares, objects needs to be collaborate with each other. So like librarian object is collaborating with the lander objects, and these are the collaboration that you can see written on the edges. So one is book request, and second, you can see lookup in the index and return info. And in the fourth is get title from a string and return book. And the sixth, return the book. So collaboration diagrams also, you also write the sequence of activity that is going to perform by numbering. One of the other diagram which is simpler than the collaboration diagram, and it is just the extension. So basically collaboration diagram ko ek aur tarike se batane ke liye we have another diagram which called sequence diagram. So sequence diagram normally depict the sequence of activities that are going to perform, and here for each object or each entity you have the timelines that is shown as a dotted line. And just like here, the first activity is going activity was the book request. So the book request is done from lender to librarian, and in the sequence diagram if you see there is a rectangular box. So ye rectangular box jo hai ye wo hai, this shows the range of the time you can say ki jitne time ke liye us particular object ka system active hua hai. So lender is activated up to this time, and the request goes to librarian then activates, and after the activation might be into idle, and then again it when it generates the request, it again activates. So basically square jo diagram hai aapka, jo square sorry jo rectangle symbol hai wo aapka activation batata hai ki kitne time ke liye wo activate hua hai. So sequence diagram is just directly related to the collaboration diagram that you are seeing in the figure 1.5. So either you can design this or this thing. The state diagram, because all the objects are in a different state at particular time. So for example, a traffic light can be any of these following state at a particular time. So sequence of transition between state ko show karne ke liye we use the state diagram, and it is very much important because for example yahan pe de rakha hai ki we would not want to be able to go from green state to the red state. So green se direct red pe nahi ja sakte hain, and it should not be go there because suppose a gas bill is sent out to the customer who died 4 years ago. So it can be really happen if it is because the programmer somehow jo usne system banaya hai jo gas bill generate karne ka, it is not taking care of the state transition of the customer. So from state transition you can depict the various states of the objects. So one is the state diagram, is the package of views. You can describe all the packages in your whole system. One of the other diagram is component diagram. Component diagram shows the, it is similar to the package diagram, but it's more of like dividing the main sub applications of your software system. And another diagram is deployment diagram. So these are all the diagrams that we have in the UML. So एक एक करके हम सुन आज से, क्योंकि आई थिंक कुछ क्लासेस बची हैं, तो व्हाट आई विल सजेस्ट यू टू स्टडी वन पर्टिकुलर डायग्राम ऑफ यूएमएल एंड लेट्स डिस्कस वन डायग्राम इन ईच क्लास फ्रॉम नाउ ऑनवर्ड्स. सो नेक्स्ट क्लास में वी आर गोइंग टू हैव दी कोलेब्रेशन एंड सीक्वेंस डायग्राम. तो ये आप पढ़ना पहले इसमें से. सो इट हैज दी सेपरेट चैप्टर्स फॉर ईच डायग्राम नोटेशंस. व्हाट आर द नोटेशन, हाउ द ऑब्जेक्ट्स इंटरैक्ट, व्हाट आर द सिंटैक्स वी यूज टू शो द इंटरेक्शन बिटवीन द ऑब्जेक्ट्स. सो इन द नेक्स्ट क्लास यू आई आस्क. सो बेसिकली आप पढ़ के आओगे और आप क्वेश्चन पूछोगे तो ही हम इसको कंटिन्यू करेंगे, बिकॉज इन मोस्ट मोस्ट ऑफ दिस डायग्राम इट इज जस्ट जस्ट द रिप्रेजेंटेशन दैट हाउ यू रिप्रेजेंट वेरियस एंटिटीज एंड द इंटरेक्शन बिटवीन दी एंटिटीज इन दी डायग्राम. तो नेक्स्ट क्लास में हम कोलेब्रेशन एंड सीक्वेंस डायग्राम के बारे में पढ़ेंगे. So, and these diagrams will cover the second part of the OAD. So you can read that particular book, particular PDF. You will understand everything. For each diagram, there is a separate chapter. You can read it out. And we will discuss in the next lecture. If you have any doubt, any question, or anything, you can ask. Otherwise, हम यहाँ पे इसको stop कर रहे हैं. Okay, thank you.